Today I'm going to show you how to remove room echo from your videos. Let's take a look. What's up guys, Jay Lippman here. Welcome to yet another tutorial. If you're new to the channel and you're into things like video editing, camera gear, and life as a full-time creator, make sure that you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you can get notified whenever I upload a new video. Today we're diving back into sound editing and we're gonna talk about how to remove room echo from your videos. If you're anything like me, you do a lot of filming in places like this. And where is this exactly? Well, this is the room that I prefer to call my studio. It is what is supposed to be the dining room of my house, but we've kind of split it into that's the storage area back there. This is my studio. There's no walls on this side of the room. There's no doors. There's no privacy whatsoever. There's no sound treatment in the room. So a lot of times when I record, I get this room echo where the sound just reverberates off of all the hard surfaces and it comes back into, I just hit the printer again. One of these days, guys, one of these days, I'm gonna have my own studio and I'm not gonna have to worry about cramming everything in a single location. Basically, this room is just a nightmare for sound editing. Everything just sounds horrible when you record it. Now, obviously there are things in the filming process that will help with that, like making sure you're using the right mic for the right situation and making sure the microphone is fairly close to your mouth. Everything else though needs to be done in post and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. All right, so here we are in the Fairlight audio tab of DaVinci Resolve. As you can see, I have our test clip queued up and ready to go. I am going to play that for you real quick so you can hear what it sounds like. This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on the walls. There's no door. There's no walls on this side of the room. And my microphone is about 18 inches to 2 feet from my face.
Now, did you notice how there was some room echo in there? There's no sound treatment in this room, so the sound was just bouncing off the walls and reverberating back into the microphone. That's what we are trying to eliminate by using an equalizer. Now, DaVinci Resolve has three different ways that you can equalize a vocal track. One, you can equalize the entire track as a whole. Two, you can equalize the individual clips. And three, you can use the vocal channel effect on any clip or track. For this particular exercise, we're actually going to use the equalizer that's attached to the entire track just because it works better that way. There's more bands to work with, and you know what? Let's just dive in and I'll show you. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is something that I've talked about in a few different videos. We're gonna change this voice track from a stereo track to a mono track. So we're gonna right click on audio one, change track type to mono. The next thing that we're gonna do is normalize our clip. And the reason why we're doing this is because we want to clearly hear all the frequencies that we're gonna be eliminating. So I actually wanna get this clip as loud as I can get it without it clipping. So we're gonna right click on the clip. We're gonna hit normalize audio levels. We'll do -3 and normalize. From there, we're gonna come over to our mixer. We're gonna double click on EQ to open up the equalizer. Let's go ahead and activate band 1 and band 6 so we can have our high pass and our low pass filters. Next thing we're gonna do is change bands 2 and bands 5 to a Q pattern. And then we're gonna raise the Q factor of bands 2, 3, 4, and 5 as high as they will go. And from here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna raise the gain on each one of those bands in the equalizer one by one in order to catch the frequencies that are causing the most unpleasant sounds. And then we're gonna drop the gain in all of those bands. And I like starting from the higher pitched sounds. So we're gonna come over to band 5. We're gonna raise the gain as high as it'll go, which in this case is +20. And we're gonna go ahead and listen to our clip and listen for the most unpleasant noises.
This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on the walls. There's no door. There's no walls on this side of the room. And my microphone is about 18 inches to 2 feet from.
So you hear that whistling, that's what we're listening for. And we're gonna turn the gain on that band right there at that frequency all the way down. Go over to gain, bring it down to -20. I'm gonna come over to band 4, we're gonna raise the gain all the way and we're gonna do the same thing.
This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on the.
That one sounds good. Bring that gain all the way down. Raise the gain on band 3. Listen again.
Walls on this side of the room, and my microphone is about
18 inches to 2 feet from my face. This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on.
That's good. Bring the gain all the way down. And finally, band 2.
The walls. There's no door. There's no walls on this side of the room. And my microphone is about 18 inches to 2 feet from my. This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on the walls. There's no door.
Bringing the gain all the way down. And just from doing that, our clip went from sounding like this.
This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on the walls. There's no door. There's no walls on this side of the room. And my microphone is about 18 inches to 2 feet from my face.
To sounding like this.
This is the sound from the room that I like to call my studio. There's no sound treatment on the walls. There's no door. There's no walls on this side of the room. And my microphone is about 18 inches to 2 feet from my face.
Now, obviously, the job's not done. There's still a lot of editing to do in order to get my voice sounding the way that you're hearing it right now. But that one little thing, getting rid of those unwanted frequencies, is going to diminish the room echo if you're not in a sound-treated room by a lot, and it's going to take your voice to the next level. All right, guys, like this video if you enjoyed it. Share it if you think your friends will enjoy it. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell if you haven't done so already. I'll be back on Monday with a brand new video. But until then, thanks for hanging out, and I'll talk to you later. See ya.